Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In the previous session you have learned how to layer mask in Photoshop, and in this session you are going to be learning how to create a clipping mask in Photoshop. So in this photo frame we want to insert a photo, and to do that we are going to be using clipping mask. So let's insert an image. Drag and drop it here, and we will hold shift and drag from the corner to increase it. Let's place it here. Now we have to make selection of this area. To do that we will select this layer and we will select the magic wand tool to make the selection. We will click here and that's it. So we will press Ctrl J to create a layer using that selection. Here it is. And now we will right click on this layer and select the create clipping mask. This is it. The layer is clipped here. Now you can change the position of this clipping mask. And anytime you want, you can right click and select the release clipping mask to release the clipping mask. And that's how you can create a clipping mask within an image or within a selected area. Let's see how to do it on a text. So here is another image. We're gonna create a text here first. Just select the type tool and type clipping mask and place it here. So now we have to bring the image. We'll drag and drop it here. We'll fix the position and then we'll press enter. And let's use the keyboard shortcut to do it. We'll press Ctrl Alt Z from the keyboard and it's done. So you can again press Ctrl Alt Z to release the clipping mask like this, and let's do it again. So the best thing is you can, when you apply it to text, you can edit it. You can select the type tool and change the text, and it will still maintain the clipping mask. You can also change the positioning of the image which is inside. So if you have learned my previous lesson, then you may think what would happen if I use the layer mask instead of the clipping mask. Let's distinguish this clipping mask and layer mask. Hold Alt and hover over this line, and when you see this symbol, and then you can click here to release the clipping mask. This is another way of clipping or releasing any layer. And now we will hold Ctrl and click here to make the selection, and we will click here to create the layer mask. In this case, the positive thing of using a layer mask is you don't need this text anymore because it is independent. And the negative thing is this is not an editable text, so you can't edit this text anymore. This is just a selection which is converted to a layer mask. If you try to change the position of the image inside like before, then you see you are moving the entire image. To do that, now you have to unlink this from here, and then you can change the position of this image inside. And then it's a good practice to link it again. This is a negative thing using a layer mask instead of a clipping mask. So this is the basic difference between the clipping mask and layer mask. One more thing about the clipping mask is this clipping masks are not only applicable to this kind of images. You can also apply clipping mask for any adjustment layers as well. Let's create an adjustment layer from here. you select invert. So that's the invert effect. So if I again hold alt and hover over this line and click here and clip it to the text, then you can see now we are using the clipping mask for an adjustment layer, which is here. So that's all for this lesson, and with this lesson we have completed chapter 4. From the next lesson we will start chapter 5, which is about image adjustments, and in that chapter I will discuss more about this kind of adjustment layers. So you can subscribe to this channel to stay connected. Thanks for watching this lesson. Hope to see you in the next chapter.